All right, so I'm not sure how many of you are philosophy simps, but the past few years for me, I've been getting into philosophy a lot more than I used to. There's two sort of 19th century philosophers that I tend to oscillate between, the ideology, I guess, of both, depending on my mood. So the first one, and these are both German dudes. From the 1800s. The first one's Schopenhauer, right? Now, Schopenhauer's whole deal was he looked around at life and he's like, dude, this shit sucks. Like, you look at everything in life, it's just fucking, animals eating other animals, fucking, life is by default, you will experience pain in life, right? Like, that's a guarantee. It doesn't matter who you are, you're going to experience pain. But the thing is, it isn't a guarantee that you'll experience pleasure, okay? And here's the thing too. Even when you are in, all your needs are met and you're in a content state, that gets boring, right? So even when everything's good and perfect, you're gonna get bored. And boredom is kind of suffering in and of itself, right? So there's no way to avoid suffering in this world. And that's something that, every religion is aware of, Buddhism specifically. Life is suffering, right? By default, life is suffering. And you may be thinking, oh, you're just being pessimistic, you're being negative, Yeah. Yeah, good job, bud. It is definitely a depressing outlook, but it's kind of what you have to arrive at if you really take a look around, in my opinion, right? But here's the thing, guys, right? There was a philosopher who came after Schopenhauer, kind of like his, I don't want to say disciple, I guess his, what's the word? His student, I guess. And you guys probably all know him at this point. He's pretty popular nowadays with the kiddos, okay? So we're living in a post, religious world, and that would be Nietzsche, okay? Now, Nietzsche, I think a lot, it pisses me off in a way because a lot of people nowadays attribute nihilism to Nietzsche, right? Like, oh, he was the philosopher that was a nihilist. Okay? Nietzsche was not a nihilist. Nietzsche was trying to find a remedy for nihilism. Nietzsche predicted that nihilism would sort of overtake the world once, religion fell out of fashion, which it obviously is now. We have more scientific discoveries every day that make it more likely that this whole, Abrahamic religion, Jesus, whatever, whoever you believe in, that's probably not how what's going on here, right? So Nietzsche sort of took Schopenhauer's whole philosophy of, life is shit, life is suffering, and he's like, okay, I got you, man. I hear you. But we have to do something about that. We have to try our best to, he called it affirming life, right? And that's we have to try our best to make the best out of a bad situation, okay? I'm not sure how many of you have heard about the Übermensch, the idea of the Übermensch, which translated from German means the overman, which is basically, or is it Superman? It's one of the, I think it's, yeah. Basically, what that means is someone, it means a lot of things, but what I take it to mean is someone who, despite the atrocity of existence, is able to look it in the eye and be like, "Bitch, I don't give a shit. I'm living my best life regardless, okay? I'm going to affirm you even though you're terrible, okay?" And here's the thing. I think Nietzsche was capping. I think he was coping a little bit, okay? I think he was not in such a good state of mind. So I think this whole life-affirming, ideology, and it is a cope, okay? Let's be honest, it is a cope. But here's the thing. It's a necessary cope. Nietzsche eventually kind of went insane. He lost his mind. He was like a drug addict. And yeah, he lost his mind. And I think that's kind of the path that I guess I want to say people like me or people who kind of, take a big picture look at existence. That's kind of the path for us if we don't sort of try our best to affirm life, right? So I think it's easy to to see life as great and wonderful, I think it's also easy to see life as total garbage. The hard thing, the hardest thing you can do is to recognize life as garbage and to still, you know, enjoy your time here regardless, right? I don't even know how to begin being able to do that. But it's something that, you know, we have to do. It's something Nietzsche would have wanted it, okay? We gotta make sure that Nietzsche's satiated beyond the grave here. But yeah, man, it's definitely a tough thing to do. And here's the thing. I haven't lived that hard of a life. The hardest part about my life is just the loneliness, you know? It's hard for me to... You know, it's hard for someone who thinks the way I do to really have friends or, you know, I've been screwed over a lot in my life. So the hardest part about life for me is other people, to be honest, you know, but yeah, they're just when you really take a broad look at what existence is, it's hard to affirm it. It really is hard to affirm it. But, you know, that's kind of what you have to do. You know, Nietzsche coined the term the opium of the masses, right? That's what religion was, because religion's the ultimate cope in a way, you know? Okay, maybe this earthly world is suffering, but at the end of the day, when I die, I'm going to end up in a, you know, a heavenly landscape where I get freaking 32 brides or whatever the hell. I get to fuck virgins all day. Like, yeah, that sounds kind of sick, man. But here's the thing, right? That's not what's going on. And maybe for you it is. Maybe that's what you think will happen. And listen, more power to you. If that's, you know, I would call it a cope, you would just call it a way of life. And if that's what makes you happy, then go for it. You know, I was raised in a religious household. And I honestly, I'm sorry if this offends anybody. Well, I'm not really sorry, but I think I would chalk up teaching your children religion. I think that's kind of child abuse. You know, at least it was in my case. It's just repressive, man, at the end of the day. Like, if you want to be a Christian, you want to be a Muslim, whatever you want to be, go for it. But don't put that on your children. Okay. You know, I'm a nihilist nowadays. I'm totally a-religious. But yeah, I think when growing up, you know, I was forced to go to, my parents literally put me in a fucking Christian school, dude. Like they took me out of public school, put me in a Christian school. Eventually I went back to public school, but I never was able to make friends throughout my life because I was, you know, they kept switching me between schools and I was never really able to form a solid friend group. Putting me in a fucking religious school was a really smart idea on my mom's part. So GG mom for that. But yeah, man, that's a whole tangent though. Maybe I'll make another video on that, how I think the whole religion imparting that shit on your kids is kind of a child abuse. I'll make a video on that. That's an interesting subject. But anyways, my whole point with that is, you know, as much as it seems like a good idea for you to be religious or whatever, that's great. You know, I don't wish I was religious, because that religion never really worked for me, honestly, as a cope. You know, the whole idea of heaven is just more existence. It's like, I'm kind of sick of this whole existing thing, man. If you haven't figured it out by now, this isn't the most uplifting YouTube channel, but yeah, what's my whole point with this? Basically, Nietzsche was really ahead of his time. I mean, so was Schopenhauer, obviously. But I feel like it doesn't take a fucking brain surgeon to realize what this existence is. But yeah, and I don't have any answers. All I'm going to say here is we need to find a collective cope for humanity that'll kind of push us forward. Or maybe not. Maybe we'll just go extinct and that'll be the end of the human race. I don't really give a shit either way. However, in the short term, while I'm here and while my fellow humans are here, as much as I despise all you fuck, I still want you to kind of have a happy life while you're here. And I see a lot of people are just totally stuck in a void of nihilism nowadays. And that's understandable, you know, so am I. It's a late stage capitalist world. Everybody's sort of alienated from each other, you know, their labor. Life's kind of shit, man. And I don't know what it is, but I think we need a new sort of opium for the masses. And maybe that has not that's probably has nothing to do with religion. I don't want it to really have anything to do with religion. I think we need to find something, is all I'm saying. But yeah, I think, and I used to think it was art. Nietzsche would have said art is sort of the best cope for the future, but now with like AI shit, it's like, okay, well, maybe that's not gonna work anymore. So I don't fucking know, man. Maybe we're all just fucked. I have no idea. I don't really have like a happy note to leave this video on. I just kind of wanted to talk about this a little bit. This video probably won't get any views because it's not gonna have like a catchy title or whatever. But yeah, if you watch the whole thing, thanks for watching. Leave a comment. I'm not gonna tell you to like the video or whatever. That's so fucking cringy. I hate like soliciting bullshit from my viewers. But I do want to comment, not even for like the algorithm. I don't give a shit. I just want to have a discussion, really, to be honest. So yeah, leave a comment if you want, and yeah, thanks for watching.